Hello everyone and welcome to another video review by Centipede Geek. In this video I'll be talking about the HBO Max television series by the name of Gossip Girl. Obviously it comes from the older show. It's almost like a soft reboot sequel in a way that does references or does pay homages to the original show. I won't be talking much about the original Gossip Girl. My wife always has to sort of catch me up on things that have happened because I don't catch the homages and stuff like that because I never really watched the old show. So like I said, I really won't be talking about it, so sorry about that. But so Gossip Girl, it's an HBO Max television show. It's had 6 episodes, and I was wondering why it hadn't been coming on the past couple of weeks, and because they have split it into two different, it's one season, but it's two different blocks where the first 6 episodes air now, and then the next batch of episodes won't air till later on in November of this year. So we've got a couple of months wait. So let's talk about these first several episodes. We've had 6 episodes, and the first episode was called Just Another Girl on the MTA. It originally aired July 8th of this year. And the most recent episode, titled Parent Side Episode 6, aired August 12th of 2021. So just a couple of weeks ago, about 3 weeks ago. Overall, what have I thought of this soft reboot or sequel? Like I said earlier, I don't know much about the original show, so like I said, I won't be talking about it. Overall, I've really enjoyed these first 6 episodes. I will say it is one of those shows that has really had to grow on me. I wasn't sure if I was going to like it. I was 2 episodes in, and my wife was really liking it a lot, but I was like, I don't know. I'm not sure if the show is catered to my audience. Maybe it's catered to people that liked the original show. I don't know. It didn't seem to really, I guess, cater to me. And that was until the 3rd episode. And all these things that I thought were going to happen at the end of the season happened in episode 3. The sisters coming at odds and us finding out about why she was kicked out of her old school and why she had to come to this school and all that kind of stuff. I thought this was like finale kind of stuff of the season, but it happened in this episode. And see, in episode 3 of this HBO Max television series, the name of Gossip Girl, is the reason I kept watching because I really started to like it after that. I will say some of the things I really do like about the show after that episode was that I like how they're doing a lot more inclusion and stuff like that with gay and bisexual characters and stuff like that. I like how they're not trying to put a label on certain characters, and you'll have to forgive me if I don't pronounce certain names right. The character with the pink hair, I forget his name, but I like how they don't exactly put a label on him at first, and he doesn't exactly know what he is, and then he kind of makes a decision later on that he's bisexual. And then you have that really sad scene. I think it's episode, I want to say it's episode 5, if I'm not mistaken, maybe you correct me, with the great actor by the name of Malcolm McDowell that plays his father. I've always liked that actor. And he comes out on air and says, you know, how could I be against gay people when my son is bisexual? And it's before his son has come out to everyone. It's before his son has came out in public. And it's just a really sad scene where his father may have not have meant anything alone by that scene, but obviously it's going to have some effects on his son and stuff like that. And overall, that was just a really sad scene. But I really liked the last episode that aired too, where we have, and I believe it may not have been in the last episode, but it was right there at that same deal where we have this protest going on because of these buildings that are being built, if I'm not mistaken, and they're holding up these signs, and it was just a really neat scene. Overall, I really liked that scene. Overall, it's a pretty cool show. I will say there's a lot of characters in the show that are really hard to like. You try to like the characters later on, but then they end up doing things you don't like that they did. For example, you have this, and once again, it's another character I forget, but the character that's sleeping with the teacher. He's one of those characters you don't like at first. Later on, you end up kind of feeling sorry and feeling pity for him because the teacher's trying to say that he has a, you know, sexually transmitted infection and all that kind of stuff. So you end up feeling for him later on, but at first you don't really seem to like him too much. I will say there's a couple characters that I can't stand to like at all, and those are the teachers and the whole Gossip Girl Instagram account that they have on social media. These are characters that are trying to take the attention off them because teachers are being fired in the school, and they're trying to put the attention on the students so the students will do better in school and take the attention off the teachers. And it seems to be working for the most part. They look at themselves as, I guess you could say, vigilantes for the cause, or whatever you want to call themselves. They see themselves as doing the right thing, but in my opinion, it's morally and ethically wrong. They're by no means doing the right thing, outing these students on social media, you know, making a mockery of these students' lives and putting things on social media that is no one else's business by a long shot. Can't get behind the teachers at all, especially when you're trying to root for these younger students, as these younger students have a whole livelihood ahead of them, right? I will say, it's one of those shows that while, in my opinion, it's always nice to have someone you can relate to and someone you feel like, you know, I feel like I'm like this character, or I feel like I can relate to this character because we have certain things in common. I don't feel like I can, not that this is a bad thing, but I don't feel like I can relate to any of the characters in Gossip Girl. These are rich characters that come from a rich background, rich students that come from rich parents that go to a rich school, and I don't feel like I have anything in common with any of them. Like I said, it's not necessarily a bad thing, but it's always nice to know when you have something that you can relate, you can, you know, characters that are relatable to real life. That way the characters, to me at least, seem more realistic. And to me, these are people that are all too obsessed with social media, and they're all too obsessed with Instagram. And maybe it does portray to real life a little bit as people become more and more obsessed with social media and phones and Facebook and Twitter and stuff like that. It really shows how much of an attachment we have to our devices and stuff like that. But it just, to me, this show, just the characters aren't very relatable. But besides that, that's really my only critique on the show. Overall, I really enjoyed the episodes. I really like the inclusion that the show has with modern storylines of different gay and bisexual stuff and stuff like that. I don't know the title of the next episode, but it'll be episode 7, and according to my sources on Wikipedia here, it will air in November later on this year and probably have another 6 episodes or so. Sounds like it'll have about 12 episodes or so, and if it doesn't, I'll make sure to make a video updating you guys. But once again, that's my review of the first 6 episodes of the HBO Max television series with the name of Gossip Girl. Thanks for watching, and make sure to like, comment, and subscribe below.